the creator of the role of Sweeney Todd and Tony Award winner for the same role, Mr. Len Cariou.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Stephen Sondheim, Harold Prince, and Hugh Wheeler are really responsible for two of the peaks of my musical theater career. But he is also responsible for one of the valleys. As follows, Steve has a reputation for procrastination. I think Ned called it persistence, but whatever it's called, he's guilty. When we went into rehearsal for A Little Night Music, there were only 8 of the 15 songs that eventually ended up in the score written. And one of those songs was a crucial number, the 11th hour number, that my character Frederick, the middle-aged lawyer, me, goes to his former lover, Desiree, Glynis Johns, and says, although he really still holds a great deal of affection for her, he's terribly enthralled with his new 18-year-old virgin bride, and that the relationship could not be renewed. What a wonderful idea for a song, I thought. I mean, it's touching, it's not sentimental. I was dying to hear it. Now, the week before we were to go to Boston for the out-of-town tryouts, Stephen still had not written the song. In the meanwhile, Hal and Glynis and Hugh and I had rewritten the scene by working on it, and we, to encourage Steve, brought him down to a rehearsal. And after he watched Glynis and I plow through this, he jumped up, thanked us profusely, and ran home. The next day, he came back, disheveled, eyes all hollow, but under his arm was the song. So he sits down at the piano, and he starts to sing, "Isn't it rich? Are we a pair?" Frederick, I thought. This is Frederick, it sounds more like Desiree. When it was over, sure enough, he turned to me and he said, "Sorry, Len, that's the way Hal directed it." Now, here is The Night Waltz, which opened A Little Night Music, followed by a song from Follies, then one from Sweeney, and then my song. Or what should have been my song.